So the next important question we will start studying now is, when does there exist a solution to the differential equation? If we are given with a differential equation, x dot of t is equal to f of x, in which now x has n components. At any time instant t, x has n components, and hence f is a map from Rn to Rn. And for this situation, suppose we are given with the initial condition x naught, x at time t equal to 0 is some vector called x naught, which is an element of Rn. We are interested in the question. Suppose this is our space Rn, this is our point x naught, then the direction is given here by f evaluated at the point x naught. We are interested in answering the question, when does there exist a trajectory that starts from the point x naught at t equal to 0, and there is a unique trajectory for some time duration, for a time duration 0 to delta, in which delta is some positive number, possibly very small, but for this duration of time we have a unique solution to the differential equation x dot is equal to f of x. So this is the question we will answer in the next few lectures starting from now. So let us look at this differential equation. So given d by dt of x is equal to f of x, and the initial condition x0 is equal to x0, an element in Rn, when does the solution exist? Then we will ask, if a solution exists, when is it unique? Under what conditions on f at the point x0 do we have a solution, and when is it unique? So please note that we are interested in a solution possibly for a very small interval of time. It might be difficult to guarantee existence and uniqueness of solutions for a large duration of time, but we are interested only for an interval 0 to delta, in which delta is greater than 0, possibly quite small. So we ask, is continuity of f the important property here, or is it differentiability of the function f at the point x naught that is required here? So it is important to note here that while continuity of the function f is sufficient for existence of solutions, uniqueness of the solution is not guaranteed by just continuity of the function f. On the other hand, while differentiability of the function f guarantees both existence and uniqueness of the function f, both existence and uniqueness of solution to the differential equation x dot is equal to f of x, this differentiability of f is not essential for guaranteeing existence and uniqueness of the solution. So keeping note of this, we can ask, what is the important property required for existence and uniqueness of solution to a differential equation? It appears to be a property that is a slightly more strong condition than continuity, but might not be as strong as differentiability of the function f at the specified initial condition x naught. So it turns out that this property is an important property called Lipschitz condition on the function f. So what is the definition? This definition is valid for a function f from Rn to Rm. Even though in our case f is always from Rn to Rn, we will define this definition of Lipschitz for a case when f is a map from Rn to Rm. So it is said to be locally Lipschitz at a point x0 if there exist a neighborhood B of x0 of radius epsilon. We will see a precise definition of a neighborhood very soon. A neighborhood B of x0 comma epsilon with epsilon greater than 0 and a constant L greater than 0, such that an inequality is satisfied. What inequality? F at x1 minus f at x2 norm, this distance is less than or equal to L times x1 minus x2, and this inequality is required to be true for all x1 and x2 in the neighborhood, in that neighborhood of the point x0. So this neighborhood is being called as a ball B centered at x0 and of radius epsilon. So this is the precise definition of the ball. So B x0 comma epsilon is defined to be the set of all points x such that distance of this point x from epsilon is strictly less than epsilon. It is not more than epsilon away from the point x naught. Even equal to epsilon away, we are not including into the ball b x naught comma epsilon, and hence this is called an open ball around x naught of radius epsilon, around which point the ball is centered, that is centered around the point x naught, and what is the radius, that is epsilon, and we are saying it's an open ball because this distance is strictly less than epsilon. So this ball is contained in Rn because we are taking all points in Rn that satisfy this condition. So for some ball around the point x naught with a radius strictly greater than 0, we should be able to guarantee that this inequality is satisfied for all x1, x2 inside this ball. So this number L, a positive number L, is said to be a Lipschitz constant. It is not unique, because if we have found a constant L such that this inequality is satisfied for all x1, x2 in the ball B, x0, epsilon, then you can take a number larger than L. For that larger L also this inequality would be satisfied, and hence we see that this Lipschitz constant is not going to be unique. But in general, this Lipschitz constant L will depend on x naught and on epsilon. It will depend on the point x naught itself and also on the radius epsilon of the ball, of the open ball around x naught. So, using this definition of Lipschitz function, it is possible to specify under what conditions solution to a differential equation exists and when it is unique. So, we will see some examples of a Lipschitz function and of some non-Lipschitz functions. So, the line fx is equal to minus 4x is locally Lipschitz at the point x equal to 3. If it is Lipschitz, then we should be able to give a number L such that inequality is satisfied, and here we can take L is equal to 4. So, notice that we can take the slope of the function f, absolute value of the function f, or we can take something larger. To understand the Lipschitz function, we will take graph of a function f for the situation that f is a map from R to R. Suppose this is our point x naught and this is a graph of the function. So, what does this say? F is said to be Lipschitz at the point x naught if there exists a ball of radius epsilon, which means that this point is x naught plus epsilon, this point is x naught minus epsilon, and both these points are not included in the ball because it is an open ball. In other words, this interval is an open interval. So, for this particular ball, we require some inequality to be satisfied. So, we take all the points, take any two points x1 and x2 in this ball, and we look at the corresponding distance between them, and when we connect. It is required to draw a larger figure to be able to see what the Lipschitz condition is specifying on the function f. This is the point x naught. This is a ball. In this case, it is an interval of width 2 epsilon, an open interval of width 2 epsilon in which the center is x naught. Suppose we take x1 here and x2 here, they don't have to be on the opposite sides of the point x naught. So, what is being specified is this is a value at x1, this is the value of f at x2, and the distance between fx2 minus fx1, the distance between fx1 and fx2, that distance is nothing but this gap. This gap divided by this gap, this ratio in absolute value should not exceed capital L. Fx1 minus fx2 in absolute value, in this case it is just absolute value, more generally it is a norm, should not exceed L. There should exist a number L such that this inequality is satisfied for all x1, x2 in the ball around x0 of radius epsilon and open ball. In this case, it is just an open interval. So, this particular ratio is nothing but absolute value of the slope of this line that connects this point and this point. Which point? The point with x1, fx1 here and x2 and fx2 here. When we connect these two by a line, then the slope of this is precisely this, but without the absolute values. Once we take the absolute values, then it is absolute value of the slope of this line, and the Lipschitz condition on f at the point x0 says that there should exist a ball around the point x0 of radius epsilon and a number L such that the line has slope of absolute value at most L. There should exist one number L such that this slope is bounded from above by L, the absolute value of the slope. So, this property of Lipschitz condition is a key property. We will see examples of Lipschitz and non-Lipschitz condition functions, and it will play a key role for existence and uniqueness of solutions to a differential equation. This is what we will see in detail from the next lecture. Thank you.